Hello everyone! In this video, we are going to learn how to use Cloudy to model a star formation region. We will run one of the sample scripts and discuss the commands being used. In this video, we will run the current version, Cloudy 17. This version brings better optimization as well as an easier management of the atomic database. The installation, however, remains the same as the one we saw in the previous video. Before we start to design our simulation, it is worthy to go over the Cloudy documentation sources. As you know, nublado.org is the official website where you can find all the relevant news regarding the software current state. To console doubts, you should first check the Frequently Asked Questions section, which will point you towards the right direction for most beginner issues. For more specific doubts regarding Cloudy physical models or technical issues, you should visit the Cloudy Plasma Simulations news group. You can use the inbuilt search function to check if any user searched your issue. If not, you can create an account and post your question. In any case, Cloudy mechanics are properly described by its documentation. You can find the files corresponding to your Cloudy version in the docs folder, which should be located in the folder where you install Cloudy. If you follow the previous video, it should be cloudy.docs. Over here, we have the quick start guide and the Hasty documentation. The former file provides a quick overview on Cloudy mechanics, how the main command works, as well as the results which can be generated. In contrast, the Hasty documentation provides a full description. It is divided in two files. The first one provides a greater introduction into Cloudy commands and how they can be used to better describe astronomical bodies. Most commands allow the user to include several arguments, and therefore it is very important to read each command description carefully. It will help you to understand which are the right unit you must use. And additionally, most command descriptions include relevant bibliographic references. The second file is focused on Cloudy structure, its outputs, the computational environment, and how to use it as a subroutine in third-party codes. It also includes many example scripts. Finally, you may encounter online a copy of a Hasty 3 documentation. This is an official documentation. However, the examples included are not updated to current Cloudy versions, and hence it does not accurately describe the software capabilities. If you search for Cloudy script examples, in addition to the places we just discussed, you can find some within the test suite folder within the Cloudy directory. In this tutorial, we're going to use one of these codes, which models a photodissociation region in the Orion nebula. As you know, between the Orion constellation belt and its brightest star, Rigel, you can find a diffuse spot on the sky. This nebula is a very young star formation burst with a diameter between 30 to 40 light years. In the optical range, the widespread light is generated by the surrounding gas, which is being ionized by very massive stars. These stars represent the minority within the stellar population distribution. However, the photons they generate are very energetic, and they can effectively ionize the circumstellar gas, as well as dissociating the progenitor molecular cloud before more stars have time to form. To explain this gas-dominated light, we can use Cloudy. Let us go over the test suite example. As you may have imagined, the first command, title, stores the following strings as the title for the simulation. This reference will be included in the output files, and hence it is useful to organize your models. However, it is completely optional. Moreover, any line starting with these symbols will be ignored, and they can be used to comment your scripts. Additionally, you can use C and a space at the beginning of any line, and it will not be executed in the simulation, but it will be included in the printed code output. The following lines describe the radiation sources for simulation. It is important to understand that Cloudy needs you to specify both the strength and the shape of the radiation streaking the cloud. The field strength can be described as either a luminosity or an intensity. In the former case, we provide the total energy emitted by the central star and an inner radius to the gas cloud. In the intensity case, however, we must provide the flux striking the cloud. Cloudy includes several options to characterize this radiation, and it is important to understand how they work. For example, you could use a blackbody command with a temperature to define the incident continuum, but you would also need additional commands such as luminosity or radius to describe its strength. In this particular case, we have the set command, which loads a stellar atmosphere for crudes et al. At this temperature. This simulates the spectrum of the Orionis C star in the Trapezium system. This command may not work for you now, but for the time being, do not worry. In the next video, we will see how to import stellar atmospheres into Cloudy. The Phi command provides the influx of hydrogen ionizing photons. This command expects a log unit, so this represents 10 European billion photons. Over here, we can see an additional incident radiation field. This is a Bergstrahlung continuum from the free-free interaction between hydrogen ions and electrons. This number defines the characteristic temperature in log units, as long as it is less or equal than 10. Hence, this is 1 million Kelvin degrees. This high temperature is explained by X-ray emission caused by winds near the trapezium stellar system. As in the previous case, we use the phi command to quantify the radiation field intensity. In the next couple of lines, we describe how the plasma density changes along the ionization direction. The command H10 defines the hydrogen density at the illuminated phase cloud. This is the total hydrogen density, including ionic, atomic, and molecular populations. This is expressed in the log of particles per cubic centimeter. Additional arguments on this command include the possibility to describe the density evolution as a power law. At this point, the density would remain constant across the cloud, which is the default behavior for this command. This is changed, however, by the next one, constant pressure, which forces the total system pressure to remain constant. One feature which is being hidden in this particular script by the default settings is the cloud geometry. So far, we have described in our simulation the incident radiation source and the gas conditions within the cloud. These characteristics, however, could be applied to either an open geometry or a closed one. This choice affects the model continuum. For example, closed geometry does not produce a reflected emission. Furthermore, the diffuse fields from the illuminated phase are expected to pass across the nebula to the opposite phase. A closed geometry is the obvious choice in a planetary nebula. However, in an H2 region such as Orion, the ionizing stars might have carved out the original bubble, leaving a small covering factor. This makes the open geometry more realistic for this model. However, since this is the default geometry, we do not need to specify it. You can test this simulation using a closed geometry by adding the sphere command. You should find small divergence on the output. The following commands describe the chemical content and the dust distribution. Cloud includes several abundance sets based on observational data. For Orion, we have a chemical composition based on the observation from this nebula. However, we won't be using these observations' grains data. Instead, we will be using the grain command, which includes its own model for Orion. We will also add polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbon, or PA. In this command, the function argument varies the PA distribution across the cloud, in which 3 is an scaling factor. There are additional commands to adjust the chemical composition in cloud. For example, you can use the metals command to adjust the metallicity by a given factor. It is also possible to use the abundance command to define an arbitrary composition or just modify a certain element abundance using the element command. You will find all the available options in the Hasty documentation, as well as warnings on how these commands interact with each other. If not input is provided, Cloudy assumes a solar metallicity for the gas. The next command, cosmic rays, forces Cloudy to include the contribution from cosmic rays in the heating and ionization of the simulated body. The background argument specifies a galactic cosmic ray background, as defined for bibliographic sources. There are more arguments such as rate or density which you can use to evaluate the effects from this energy source. The next command includes magnetic fields and turbulence to your cloud. These are not included by default. The magnetic field shape can be specified as either tangle or order. Additionally, both shapes can be specified by adding an additional magnetic field command. If not shape is specified, however, the default setting is tangle. This number is the strength of the magnetic field in logarithmic scale. The turbulence command allows you to enter the magnitude of a microturbulent velocity in kilometers per second. However, in this case we are using the equipartition argument. This forces the turbulence and the magnetic energy densities to remain equal. Since we already defined the magnetic field strength, Cloudy can calculate the microturbulent velocity using this data. For the next command, iterate, we need a bit of context. Once you start the simulation with Cloudy, it divides your model in concentric cells described internally as zones. These are thin enough for the physical conditions to remain nearly constant. Across these zones, Cloudy solves simultaneously the equations of statistical and thermal equilibrium, equations that balance ionization and neutralization processes, and heating cooling processes. Cloudy defines automatically this mesh resolution, so you don't need to worry about it. This process is done once, and then the simulation stops once we reach the boundary conditions we will describe below. In low density environments, the line transfer across these zones has a minor impact, given the fact that the lines are optically thin. However, in optically thick objects, this assumption is not valid. In these cases, it is possible to iterate the simulation. This will improve the optical depth scale using the results from the previous runs. In this particular case, we perform two calculations. You can add as an argument the number of calculations you want to do. This command also includes an argument to repeat the simulation until convergence has been reached on the optical depth estimation. As we just mentioned, Cloudy requires some input to define the outer edge of the cloud and when to stop the simulation. By default, Cloudy finishes the calculation once the gas temperature goes below the 4000 Kelvin limit. This corresponds to the photoionization boundary. Nevertheless, in this simulation, we are also interested in modeling the neutral and molecular spectra, and therefore, this is not a good limit. There are many options to set this stop limit in Cloudy. For example, we could change the lower temperature limit, but in this particular case, however, we're using the off argument. This means the gas temperature will not be used as a stop criterion. Instead, we are using the stop thickness command. This is the distance between the illuminated and shielded phase, half a parsec in linear units. In Hasty 1, chapter 15, you can find all the possible stop criteria, as well as advice on which is the most appropriate according to the astronomical object you are modeling. Finally, we reach the saving commands. Cloudy generates a global output file which contains the main simulation results. There are, however, many options to save almost all physical parameters calculated in your simulation. Over here, we have some of the save command options. For example, the save temperature command stores the average temperature weighted with respect to an atom or an ion. The save continuum stores the predicted continua, including incident, emitted, and reflected components. We can store the cooling and heating agents for each zone. The overview command, in contrast, saves the thermal and ionization structure of the cloud. Each of these commands includes its own arguments to describe units, or for example, the iterations we want to save. We can also save fluxes from individual lines. These are commonly normalized with respect to H beta, but we can also change that. Also, we can ask Cloudy to include lines, even those which are very weak. So, everything looks fine. Let's run the simulation. We open a terminal. And we go to this folder. And we run it. Okay, it is done. Cloudy has run successfully our model. Over here we can see all the results files. This one is the main one. In a future video, we will review Cloudy output files, but before that, we will check how we can change the stellar atmospheres in Cloudy and how to run model grids. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon!